you have a good science, math background, one. Second angle, too, is do you like people? Do you like to communicate with people? Do you like interaction? You have to be able to communicate with your patients in order to be able to really develop a rapport and make them feel comfortable. I mean, after all, you come in and see me, and you're coming into the nuclear medicine department for whatever kind of procedure, and the word nuclear is a little scary, you know? But it's nuclear medicine. It's the peaceful way of dealing with our radioactive atom, which is really what nuclear medicine, to me, in part, is all about.
Someone who chooses this field, you have to think, what is your motivation for doing it? And as when I go talk with, for instance, high school students and things like that, I tell them, probably first of all, do you truly have an interest in helping people through the medical field, in healthcare? I always consider healthcare a mission of mercy. I've been told that's what it is. And so often people are suffering. So in mercy, we were helping alleviate their suffering to help them get through their disease, maybe even give them a cure, or at least help give them better quality of life. We are an extension of the doctor's hands. Actually, the nuclear medicine doctors, they've all been trained to do what we do, but they can't do it. So we're out there doing, we're their hands, and then we give them the results, and then they can make decisions on that. So in that way, you're personally impacting your patient's life by being the doctor's hands and getting the results, making good quality images, getting good quality results, being very conscientious. And I think if those are the kind of things, you're into the science, the math, the physics, the human body, and just having a meaningful purpose in your life, I think that makes you a good candidate for applying to our nuclear medicine technology program.